This is a video about stem cells. Never heard that term? Don't worry, I break it down for you in easy terms. And I will explain how they can be used for erectile dysfunction and Peyronie's disease. Three reasons for this video. First, many of you have asked questions about this emerging therapy option. Second, I'm returning from a stem cell workshop today. Third reason, I have so many questions myself and have to talk about them to structure my thoughts. My wife hates it when I'm constantly blubbering about topics that puzzle me. So I guess it's your turn to listen to me. My name is Dr. Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. So what are stem cells? They can be traced back to the beginning of life. All cells of the body eventually arise from stem cells. A stem cell is like the clay of life. You can take it and mold it to any structure you like. Stem cells can become anything. Heart? No problem. Bones? There you go. Penis? You bet. Now, let's crank it up a notch. Even as an adult, you have stem cells, but they are not as versatile anymore. They have become more specialized for certain tasks. They serve as a reservoir for repair and renewal. Don't get me wrong, they are still stem cells. They can still become a lot of things, but not anything anymore. So basically, you have stem cells found in your body fat and in your bone marrow. These can be harvested for regenerative therapies. For example, a doctor can perform liposuction, take out some body fat, centrifuge it, extract the stem cells, and inject them into the penis. There are studies showing a very promising effect in erectile dysfunction, for example. Before I tell you about umbilical cord stem cells and the crazy discovery of artificial stem cell engineering, I would like you to take a minute to subscribe to UroChannel and give this video a thumbs up. This is especially important to me because it signals your approval to this kind of content. I've been criticized for uploading videos about penis size. Some of you guys want me to quit that. You have signaled that you want more serious content. Here you go. Please watch it, like and subscribe. If this video doesn't get 5,000 likes by March 4th, I promise you another penis size video on March 5th. And you have yourselves to blame for that. Thank you. Okay, stem cells from the umbilical cord. Exciting stuff. They are more potent than adipose tissue stem cells or bone marrow stem cells. This means they have more potential to help with regeneration of penile tissue. And they can be obtained without any risk of complications from surgical procedures to harvest stem cells. But then, you need a donor and there are a lot of ethical and legal problems that have to be overcome. The solution is genius. Why not create stem cells artificially? Cloning technology made this possible with a breakthrough in 2006. Today, you can take a normal cell and send it back to the Stone Age, so to speak. It is possible to reprogram a normal cell to become a stem cell that then can become anything. A cell that has all the potential is called a pluripotent cell. These designer stem cells are called iPSC. This means induced pluripotent stem cells. Excuse me for the very simplified explanation. I had a suspicion that you wouldn't be able to follow along on signal pathway modulators and the embryo body method. iPSCs are really hot right now in research. Just think about it. Sure, you could revive a penis, but imagine the overwhelming potential for the cure of very severe diseases. They are tailor-made from your own body. They can be bred and amplified before use. They will amplify in the target region, which tackles one important limitation of original human stem cells. A lot of them are needed, and they only have a few days to work their magic before they die. This is because they don't multiply once injected. This problem has now been solved. However, there may be downsides to this. We don't want uncontrolled multiplication. Just think of it. This could mean reading errors of the genetic code. It could mean a risk of cancer. And what about migration? What if these cells migrate outside of the penis and settle in other organs and multiply there? Science tries to prevent this problem by integrating special switches to stop uncontrolled multiplication. So there's a lot of active research being done as I speak to overcome these concerns. But at the end of the day, many scientists prefer to work with the original human cells because of this potential threat. So the bottom line is that this is highly advanced therapy. For the moment, I can't imagine myself performing this therapy in the near future, but I think I might get there. It would make sense. But for the moment, there are too many open questions. Anyway, I will keep you informed. If you're wondering what my current treatment approach looks like, I recommend you watch these two videos. See you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.